Now, we also have a 3D image of, I believe, a baby dropping. I love these kind of images where you kind of see it happening. So tell us exactly what we're looking at, and is baby ready to come out?
Well, we're definitely seeing the baby coming out through the birth canal. As you can tell, the baby has engaged and it's already coming out through the ischial spines. You see the rotation, external rotation of the baby, as it, and its flexion, the head has to flex. And then you're gonna see the shoulders rotate in such a way that allows the shoulder from anterior to posterior position. You're gonna see the anterior shoulder being delivered first. And somehow I got stuck. Maybe a shoulder distortion. So pretty much the same image as the baby comes out through the birth canal. You see the head going through the ischial spine, the rotation of the head, the flexion of the shoulders. And we should be able to see the delivery if this continues.
I think the video stops right there, but then obviously the baby would exit.
Right. Then you see the action of the baby.
What a mirror. I just see those things. I know you've seen this thousands. I can't even. How many deliveries have you done? Do you even know?
I don't know exactly how many deliveries. When I first started practicing, my mentor, Dr. Somuano, said, make a log, but I forgot. But I've done a lot of deliveries.
Oh, my goodness. Probably in the thousands. And for you, it's just, you know, you're so used to it, but for us to see that is just so fascinating. Doctor, how can you tell the difference between having a Braxton Hicks, you mentioned Braxton Hicks, and what triggers it, or practice contractions? There's different ones, right?
Well, Braxton Hicks are contractions that are usually associated with getting the uterus ready for that time for going to labor. And Braxton Hicks occurred anytime in the third trimester. And there are irregular contractions that don't necessarily cause dilatation. So they're the same contractions as the labor contractions, but they are irregular and they do not cause dilatation.